In this lecture, we will cover an interesting problem which is based on the center of mass and projectile motion. Here we have got two masses. One is at the height h1. This is mass is same. Another mass is at height h2. At a higher height, h2 is greater than h1. They both have some charges and the height difference is also not much. And they both are projected with a horizontal velocity v. From certain height, there is a gap between them. So there is a charge, means try to understand, there is some reaction force amongst these two. So they are thrown like this. It is given that this body hits the ground at a distance L. We have to find at what height this other body will be at that point of time. Now here what is happening? There is an interaction force between them. And that force is q square upon 4 pi E0, this distance, which is again a variable. So there is a force between them, no other than gravity. Gravity is of course acting, but outside means if you look at this system of these two charges, this I take it as a system. The only force which is acting on it is G, and there is some interaction force between them, but outside force is only G. The force which is inside, the force which is acting in between two masses, will not be responsible for changing its center of mass. Please note, the force which is interaction force between two masses only, as in the case of spring, like in case of spring we have seen, if two masses are tied with a spring and I compress them, compress the spring and then release it, these kind of problems are there. What happens in such cases is that there is a stored energy and there is a spring force kx1, if this side is x1, this side is x2. Suppose the masses are different or whatever. So there is a reaction force which is equal on both. There is a reaction force because of the compressed spring. Spring is massless, so the reaction force on both the masses is same. So in such case, there is no external force acting on the system. Center of mass doesn't shift at all. So the center of mass will not shift because of the interaction of the forces between the masses. It will only shift because of G. That is what I want to say. So whatever is the center of mass here, if X bar is the center of mass here, X bar, it will only move, the center of mass will only move down because of G and because of nothing else. So the center of mass, let us see what is the center of mass now. Initial center of mass is h1 plus h2 upon 2 is the center of mass initially. Now, when this system has moved, somehow it is moving, again there won't be any this kind of a separation. Horizontal separation will not take place because there is no horizontal force on them. There is no horizontal force, whatever force is there, and they are released with the same velocity. There is no relative motion initially, so there will never be a relative motion in such cases until the horizontal force is there. So they keep on moving like this with some change in distance amongst them, this and like this. This is how it has come. So if you look at the parabola of the center of mass, it is coming like this. So my center of mass has shifted for this system by a certain height, say h. It has dropped by h. The initial height is x bar. My new height of center of mass here, when one mass has already struck, the other mass is still in the air. So my new height here would be x bar minus h, which is h1 plus h2 upon 2 minus h. where h is the height fallen by the center of mass in this time. What is the time taken? Horizontal distance is L. Time taken for the horizontal movement, vertical movement is same, object is same. So horizontal velocity also doesn't change in projectile, so you know that. So if the initial velocity is V and the impact point of one of the mass is L, then time taken will be L upon V. Now in this time, this center of mass, which is the 2SM is the mass of this system, this falls under the force of only gravity and nothing else. Interaction forces, I said, forget it. So what will be the distance which it will fall? Initial vertical velocity is zero, so S is equal to half gt square, simply. So the height which is fallen is, which is actually h, which I have taken of the center of mass, is half g, and time taken is L square upon V square. So now this distance, new distance of center of mass is, this is x1 bar is h1 plus h upon 2 minus g L square upon twice V square. I have to find out what is the height of this another body, suppose HA. Now this is at zero, ground zero. So if I want to find center of mass of this system along this horizontal in the direction of y axis, how much it is? This mass multiplied by HA plus this mass multiplied by zero, it is at ground, is equal to this x1 bar into twice m is the mass. This is how we calculate. Now I will just, if you write the formula of center of mass, it will be mha plus 0 times m upon twice m. So my ha is equal to twice x1 bar. So my height of the other thing, other ball or the mass, is h1 plus h2 minus g L square upon V square, is the height from the ground of the other mass which is yet to hit the ground.